Christ is risen. Christos voskres.
Christos anes.
Glory to God for all things. So we hear in today's Gospel, Gospel of St. John, theologian, holy apostle and evangelist, whose memory we also celebrate this day. He speaks, our Lord restores the sight of someone who is blind. More importantly, he restores the sight of someone. He restores the spiritual blindness. Someone who did not know our Lord Jesus Christ. And so in this gospel, we come to understand the different kinds of blindness that we all suffer from. For this man who was formerly blind, he suffered from an earthly blindness, of course, first and foremost, and how he had to live his life. This man who was born blind did not even know what light was, as we do, could not see things as we do. And so our Lord, who is the light, the true light, bestowed sight to this man. At first he bestowed unto him gift of vision, for to be able to see with eyes that he did not have formerly. And then, the light of understanding, spiritual light, began to penetrate within him. His spiritual eyes began to open. And he began to understand as he was being questioned who this man that had given him the sight was. That he could not be anything but someone who was a servant of our Lord, who walked with God, who pleased God, for who else could do such things? And then our Lord, coming up to him, revealed himself fully to him. And this light truly shone, the light that this man truly could see with those spiritual eyes, that this is his Lord and God and Savior. So it's with a light of understanding, a light of walking to understand truth. And of course we hear in this account the blindness of others. We have the blindness of the Pharisees, who could not get past their own pride, who could not get past the letter of the law, but instead found whatever reason they could to condemn what had been done, this good act. As we hear time and time again through the gospel, how the teachers of the law could not get past the fact that our Lord Jesus Christ was doing good on the Sabbath. And so they found this as an excuse, again, to condemn what had been done. And at first, not to even believe this man. And they had to put him on trial, so to speak. Bring in witnesses. Bring in his parents. For they would not believe him. They would not believe that this could be, that such a thing could be done. And it could be, and more importantly, it could be done by this man, who had already worked a multitude of miracles. And yet, they refused to believe that he was truly God. He was the one who was sent, the anointed Messiah. And so they found this man still hard to believe, that they could not open up their spiritual eyes. They were clamped shut with pride, envy, fear of losing their power. And they cast him out. We should also think about his parents, who did not stand up for him. And if he was left begging on the street to fend for himself, how much did they really care for him? They too suffered from blindness. Feared the Jews, feared them being cast out. They valued that more than the good thing that had been done to their son. And willing to stand up for him. So, dear brothers and sisters, we too should reflect on how open our own spiritual eyes are, how open they are to the light of Christ. For if we walk not in the light, then we too are blind. Because we are walking in darkness, the darkness that comes upon us through our sins, the passions. So we must strive to open these eyes. We must trust in our Lord. Trust in that light. Seek out that light. Seek out that truth. Seek out that love that he bestows upon us so willingly. Let us remember during these remaining days of the Pascha season to walk in that light, to seek out that truth, to live that truth, be examples of that. So that light of Christ we may clearly see with our own eyes and desire and be vessels of it for others, so that we too may be one with our Lord. And as I said, bring joy to others. Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Sessions of his most pure mother, the holy apostle and evangelist John the theologian.